Wherever you are in Manila or the Philippines or anywhere in the world, I want to welcome you to our morning worship and prayer time.
They curse and laugh, you do not fight. A thousand men yell, crucify. Crimson stains that fill your mind. You look upon me with delight. From throne to cross, you came to die. A crown for thorns to bring new life. With every nail I feel
put
Along with Every Nation churches from more than 80 nations here in the Philippines, we are studying the idea of being set apart. And today I want to talk about what it looks like to be set apart for discipleship. And when we think about set apart, there are several questions that come to mind. Set apart for what? Set apart from what? Set apart based on what? And set apart by whom? And the text we want to look at today in Matthew chapter 4, beginning in verse 18, addresses all of those questions and more. We're going to read verses 18 through 22 together. While walking by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And he said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, in the boat with Zebedee, their father, mending their nets, and he called them. Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. I pray that the Holy Spirit will help us understand, obey, believe, and act on his word. Now, when we think about this scripture, Jesus calling the original disciples, in a way setting them apart for discipleship, there are several things that become obvious to us. First of all, the being set apart for discipleship is personal. It mentions not just random people in a crowd, but mentions people by name. And Jesus knows every one of us by name. Every one of us that he sets apart for his purpose, he calls us by name. And we have here Peter and Andrew and James and John, and eventually we have others that are in this mix. But understand that it's very personal to God, and it should be personal to us. Secondly, we see that being set apart in a discipleship context is communal. It wasn't just individuals who were set apart, but they were set apart in groups. And this turned out to be a group of 12, and sometimes there were groups of 70 and various other size groups, and maybe there were multiple groups of 12 that came off of these, or maybe 10 or maybe 6. But the Christian life, the life of discipleship, the life of being set apart, is set apart with others that we do community with. It's a relational thing. And then thirdly, it was directional. It wasn't just randomly wandering around. Jesus set them apart to follow him. There was a direction. There was somewhere they were going. There was a destination. There were steps along the way. So we see that being set apart is personal, it's communal, it's directional, but it's also transformational. Jesus said, look, I'm setting you apart to follow me. He didn't say the setting apart side, but this is what it says. He's setting them apart to follow in a group. But then he promises something. I will make you fishers of men. There's something that is formative, something that transforms. You are fishermen, I will make you into something else. And it was something deeply spiritual. And there is a transformational aspect to this being set apart. So back to the questions. Set apart. Here in this text, they were set apart from what? From being fishermen. And this was a village. This was a small rural town where they were. And probably, we see in the text, their fathers were fishermen. Maybe their grandfathers, probably their great-grandfathers. As far back as you could see, this was the tradition in this village. And so part of being set apart, sometimes it takes us from something, and then secondly, for something. So they were being set apart from the traditions and the expectations that people might have had for them, and from the way that things always were, into something, from something, for the purpose of God. In this sense, following Jesus and being the original disciples who became apostles, and that was part of that transformation thing. And then based on, what is it based on when Jesus sets people apart? It's not based on ethnicity, because we see that these are Jews, but as we read through scriptures, we find he starts setting apart people of all types of ethnicities. It's not about educational level. These people didn't have education yet. They were getting it as they went. It's not about economic background. It's not about so many things that we think are impressive today. But the basis of being set apart for God is simply the sovereign choice of God for our lives. And then finally, by whom? In this story we're reading, it was by Jesus. Jesus chose these young men for his purpose. He set them apart. When I think about who has the authority, who has the responsibility, who has the right to set my life apart and your life apart for something maybe different than we had originally planned for our lives, this set apart, who has the authority to do that? A couple of nights ago, I flew in from Singapore to Manila. And when I'm going through the immigration lines, when I got to Singapore, as I was leaving Singapore, as I came to Manila, I didn't have a choice which line I got in. Whether I'm going to Singapore or coming into the Philippines, there's a line for local passport holders. There's a line for senior citizens and disabled. There's a line for diplomats. There's a line for airline crew. There's a line for foreigners, sometimes from different regions of the world, different types of passports. And my preference doesn't matter. I would always prefer the shorter line, but I don't have that authority. Someone in the immigration in the Philippines and Singapore, in any nation we fly to, has the authority to set us apart in different groups, even if it's not my preference. Contrast that with going to a restaurant. I ate some wonderful food with good friends in Singapore, and there were times when the waiter would take us to, or the hostess or the host would take us to a table, and then sometimes me or my Singaporean host would say, could we have a table over there? Maybe the view was better. Maybe there weren't so many people. It wasn't as noisy or crowded. And often, usually, in fact, I think every time, we were accommodated with our preference. And so is being set apart a matter of there's a higher authority that sets us apart and we just need to do what that is? Or is it more like a restaurant where it's a preference and somehow our preference? You know, when Jesus sets us apart, it's not like the waiter. It's more like immigration. There were clear division lines that I had no authority other than to comply. And I think that's how we is helpful to see being set apart. God sets us apart for His purpose. It's always for His glory and for our betterment, even though it might not currently be our preference. So as we think about being set apart for discipleship, I want to close in prayer and pray that God will help us understand and embrace His setting apart. Let's pray. Lord, thank You for the privilege of following You. Thank You for the privilege of following You along with others in a community. And Lord, we acknowledge that You have the right and the authority to set us apart for Your purpose as You see fit. So Lord, help us understand and believe and embrace and walk in Your purpose for our lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
So glorious, came down unashamed. You called me Yours, caught up in Your grace. You're all I need. There's nothing more beautiful than Your love. So glorious, You came down unashamed. You called me Yours, caught up in Your grace. You're all I need. There's nothing more beautiful than Your love. So
may God bless you today, tomorrow, the rest of this year, as you follow Him as His disciple.